Hi, I'm Cecile.
I'm Sabina.
I'm Calista.
I'm Francoise.
Today we're in for two special treats, chocolate truffles and mungel. We all love chocolate truffles, but who was the creator and why was it named after a very rare and precious fungus? Unfortunately, there's no definite answer to whom invented truffles and even less information on the time of invention. It is mostly believed that truffles were first made between the 1890s and 1920s. According to the legends, truffles happened by accident, just like many other important discoveries. The great French chef Auguste Escoffier was working with his crew on some pastry cream when he carelessly poured the content of the hot cream into a bowl of chocolate chunks instead of the intended bowl of sugared egg. He quickly realized that he was easily able to form balls with the chocolate paste he'd formed as an accident. As for the name truffle, it comes from the chocolate ball's strong physical resemblance to the valuable truffle fungus, once it's covered in chocolate cocoa powder. For us Americans, it can be very confusing because we call truffles any chocolate with cream filling in it. The other treat we'll be making today will be the mungel, literally beggars. It comes from the Christmas dinner of Provence in the southeast of France. People there used to serve 13 desserts symbolizing the table of Jesus and the apostles. During the Middle Ages, the four mendicant orders were associated with nuts or dried fruits served on the Christmas table. Raisins were standing for the Augustinians, hazelnuts for the Carmelites, dried figs for Franciscans, and almonds for the Dominicans. By the end of the 19th century, when chocolate became popular and way more affordable, some people began to put dried fruits on melted chocolate. That is how chocolate mungel was born. Now, are you ready? Let the feast begin.
So you will measure the cream. And we need 7 ounces of chocolate. So you will weigh the chocolate. Have you seen 17 or 16 ounces of it? You can see more how much you have. Let's see. Pop.
17.
Okay. So we need 7. Or you can cut it. Now we have to cut the chocolate. Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
Like this? You put your hand like this. Okay? So it's super easy to do. Okay, good. Then you can mix. good. So if you like the coffee, you can have a little drops of coffee. Another spices, if you like spices. Okay, a little bit more, no more pieces. Okay, so the dough is ready and it will go in the fridge for a few hours. Okay, we are ready to take the chocolate from the fridge. Small balls, go ahead, Calista. This is.
Zoom in on.
Yes. Oh, this is bad. So, you hold it to some.
And you can hold it in your hand because with the heat of your hand. And after, when you have a small ball, a nice long ball, you can roll it in the small pieces of chocolate or cacao powder, whatever you like.
Okay, this is bam.
No, it's okay. Anymore. And you can roll it in the cacao.
A bit more.
And so.
Okay, Sabina, now what are we going to do?
We're going to make the mendiants.
Mendiants.
Okay?
Okay. So, what do we need for the mendiants?
3 ounces of dark white or milk chocolate, chopped nuts, and dried fruit.
Okay, so the recipe is super simple. You have a chocolate, you are going to eat it and make a smooth round of chocolate with the back of your spoon. Make a round circle and add on the top of each circle whatever you like, nuts, dry fruit. Okay, so we have to weigh the chocolate. So we need 3 ounces of dark one. Would you weigh it for me?
Too much?
How much?
Too much. 4 grams.
And this one? utensils for this one. I'm going to cut it because you cannot cut today, huh? So you just want to melt the chocolate, not cook the chocolate, huh? Otherwise it could be burned and disgusting. Chunk. That's good. Okay. Okay, now we have the chocolate melted, so we can start. Just super easy. We take a spoon, half a spoon. So, like this. Not too close.
Okay, and then right away you put some stuff into.
And after that, you pick what you want to do. Want to do something enough thick, not too much. You can pick a raisin, a pistachio, a walnut. Usually you put sweet fruit. No. Okay. So something a little bit more warm. what I found in the fridge?
Oh, wow.
Nice truffle.
Yeah.
Then a little bit more, but we need room. So, for this. If I can find a little.
So, yeah.
After a few minutes in the fridge, should be set for longer in the fridge, but we just want to show you how it's super easy.
Yeah.
Don't touch too much, it's still a little bit warm.
Yeah.
More.
Yeah, they're
not
cold enough.
This is that. Okay, it's time to try. Calista?
Me?
Sabina? Which one do you want to pick?
This.
And you try.
Good.
Yep,
you too.
And so what?
And very good.
Yeah, good. You
yeah.
Like it?
Mm-hmm. Wow. Okay.
Okay.
So have a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. We will see everybody next year for our next adventure session of Teens Cook French Edition.